हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज पैथोलॉजिकल कैल्सिफिकेशन। कैल्सिफिकेशन इज नॉर्मली ऑकर इन अ बोन एंड एनामल्स ऑफ टीथ। सो व्हाट इज पैथोलॉजिकल कैल्सिफिकेशन? डिपोजिशन ऑफ कैल्शियम साल्ट इन अ टिश्यू अदर देन ऑस्टाइड एंड एनामल इज कॉल्ड एज अ पैथोलॉजिकल कैल्सिफिकेशन, इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज हिटेरोटॉपिक कैल्सिफिकेशन। देर आर टू टाइप्स, डिस्ट्रॉपिक कैल्सिफिकेशन एंड मेटास्टैटिक कैल्सिफिकेशन। Dystrophic calcification is occur over the dead and degenerated tissue where the deposition of calcium salt. But here the normal calcium metabolism and the blood calcium level is also the normal. Causes of dystrophic calcification: dystrophic calcification in dead tissue and dystrophic calcification in degenerative tissue. So what are the causes in the dead tissue? In case of casus necrosis, whenever there is a formation of guma, the giant cell, when it is formed, so there is a deposition of calcium over that cells which is dead there and gives a cheese-like appearance. In case of liquefactive necrosis, after a chronic abscess, when the dead cells are there, the deposition of calcium. In case of fat necrosis, after acute pancreatitis, the deposition of calcium there and gives a soap-like effect. It's called as soapification. In case of infarct, after the infarction, the deposition of calcium over the dead cells, even though in case of sometimes in the myocardium also. In case of venous thrombosis, the deposition of calcium can produce a plebolysis. In case of hematoma of bones, where the deposition of calcium at there, which is abnormal. Even though after a death of parasite, especially in the hydatic cyst. Hydatic cyst is caused because of Echinococcus granulosus. When this Echinococcus granulosus forming a hydatic cyst, when the cells are died, the parasite is died inside, and after that the deposition of calcium over that dead parasite. This is a other example of a calcification, of dystrophic calcification. Calcification in the some cancerous condition like a breast cancer. Even though in the congenital toxoplasmosis, when the CNS is get involved, the calcification is seen in the infant brain, where the infant brain has deposited a calcium salt. Now we see what are the causes of a calcification in the degenerated cell. When the cell get degenerated, in case of old scar, which is a dense old scar, which may go under the hyaline degenerative changes, which further develop a calcification. In case of atheromas in the coronary artery, where the atheroma, after the atheroma, there is a deposition of calcium. In case of Mockenberg sclerosis, there is a deposition of calcium salt in the muscular artery, especially in the medial layer, in the tunica media, this condition occur in the elder person. Even though in case of assist, after a prolonged time, if the cyst is there, even though, for example, we can take a epidermal cyst, since a prolonged time, the cyst over the epidermal, where there is a deposition of calcium salt, can causes a dystrophic calcification. There is one condition is called as calcinosis cutis. And this irregular nodular deposition of calcium ions along with the phosphate deposited in the skin and subcutaneous tissue. So these are the some causes which causing the dystrophic calcification. Pathogenesis of a dystrophic calcification. Serum calcium level is within a normal limit. But what happened here? Denatured protein which is in the dead cell, in the necrotic cells or degenerated cells, which bind with the phosphate ion, because calcium attracts towards the phosphate and forming a precipitate of calcium phosphate. So here the not only the calcium is deposited, along with the calcium ion there is some other ions, it's like a phosphate, is also get deposited. So calcium phosphate is deposited. The process of dystrophic calcification, there are first is the initiation, where the formation of this calcium phosphate, that because that get accumulation of that calcium phosphate in the cell and outside the cell, in the cell in the mitochondria, and in the outside the cell there is a extracellular membrane bound vesicles, and when it is being accumulated goes into somewhere else, the process called as propagation. Propagation is a phase in which a mineral which is deposited in the initiation phase get propagated to form a mineral crystals. So this is the formation of dystrophic calcification. So first is the initiation and the second is the propagation. Now the second type is the metastatic calcification. We see the dystrophic calcification is occur over the dead and degenerative tissue. Here the metastatic calcification occur in a normal tissue. There is a irreversible injury. Here it is dystrophic calcification is a reversible. This is caused because of hypercalcemia, excessive calcium. That excessive calcium may be because of two causes. Excessive mobilization of calcium from the bones, or excessive absorption of calcium from the guts. So what are the causes of excessive mobilization of calcium from the bones? In case of hyperparathyroidism, which releasing cholecalciferol, that parathyroid gland. But what happened if it is being hyperparathyroidism, along with this, that forming primarily due to parathyroidal adenoma. the excessive mobilization of calcium. And then after that, secondary development of parathyroidal hyperplasia, enlargement of parathyroid gland. And with this process, that goes into a chronic renal failure. And because of this, excessive immobilization of calcium from the bones. Second is a bony destruction in case of multiple myeloma, in case of metastatic carcinoma, the destruction of bone is there. So because of destruction of bones, the calcium mobilized from the bones and somewhere else. Third is the prolonged immobilization of patient that result in disuse, atrophy of bone if the patient was prolonged bedridden. That causing a disuse, atrophy of bone and hypercalcemia. So that calcium which is secreted, that mobilize from the bone and somewhere else. Now, what are the conditions that causes excessive absorption of calcium from the guts? Vitamin D is a very good source of calcium. But vitamin D is a fat soluble vitamin. So it is causing a vitaminosis. So excess of vitamin D that increase the calcium absorption, that may causes a metastatic calcification. In case of milk alkali syndrome, especially occur in babies, because of excessive oral intake of calcium in the form of milk, or in adult, administration of a drug like calcium carbonate and antacid, which is used in the treatment of peptic ulcer. The third cause of hypercalcemia is hypercalcemia in infant. That also causes excessive absorption of calcium from the guts. So what are the site of metastatic calcification? In the kidney, at the basement membrane of tubular epithelium and in the tubular lamina, causing a nephrocalcinosis. And because of this, a patient may go into a chronic renal failure further. In lung, especially in alveolar walls, in stomach, on the acid secreting fundal glands, in the blood vessel, on the internal elastic lamina, over the cornea, and synovium joint, causing a pain and dysfunction. So what are the pathogenesis of metastatic calcification? Metastatic calcification occurs due to excessive binding of inorganic phosphate ion with the calcium ion, which are elevated due to underlying metabolic degeneration. So when the calcium ion and the phosphate ion are bind together, that causing a metabolic degeneration, causing a metabolic derangement. This lead to the formation of precipitate of calcium phosphate, at the peripheral site. Metastatic calcification is a reversible, that I told you, upon a correlation of whatever the underlying metabolic disorder. Okay. So these are about the pathological calcification. Thank you for the watching.